Around 150 Chinese vessels remain in the West Philippine Sea. This was revealed by the National Security Council to the House of Representatives during plenary deliberations on the 2022 budget. According to Muntinlupa Representative Rufy Biazon, who is the NSC's budget sponsor, the Chinese vessels look like civilian ships, but they could also be maritime militia conducting work for the Chinese government. Biazon said the NSC is recommending the deployment of civilian vessels and the acquisition of more military vessels to assert the country's rights in the area.
Ang recommendation, Mr. Speaker, is to increase our presence in by means of patrolling the ocean. And therefore, the recommendation is for us in Congress to grant their fund request for the addition of vessels that may operate. And of course, to continue the diplomatic efforts that our country is doing each time that there are incidents involving foreign vessels who intrude into our exclusive economic zone.
President Rodrigo Duterte has certified the necessity of the 2022 national budget. The chief executive invoked Article 6, Section 26 of the Constitution in issuing the certification. This means lawmakers don't have to wait for the 3 days usually required to approve a bill on final reading after approving it on second reading. Duterte said the quick passage of the more than 5 trillion peso spending plan is needed to ensure budgetary preparedness that will enable government to perform its duties. But not all lawmakers are happy about the president's move. Kabataan Party List Representative Sara Ilago says that basically made their budget deliberations pointless and deprived lawmakers of the opportunity to fight for more funding for health, education, and livelihood. Gabriela Women's Party also fears a railroading of the budget. The House of Representatives has adopted the Senate version of the proposal clarifying the income taxation of private schools. This brings the bill a step closer to being transmitted to President Rodrigo Duterte for signature. The measure imposes a preferential tax rate of 10% of taxable income prospectively. It also allows private schools to avail of the 1% tax rate under the Corporate Recovery and Tax Incentives for Enterprises Act or CREATE law. House Ways and Means Committee Chairman Joey Salceda says the reduced tax rate could help private schools rehire teachers who were displaced during the pandemic and lower the tuition of students. The Philippine Commission on Elections asserts it can no longer extend the period of voter registration for the 2022 polls beyond October. On Wednesday, the COMELEC agreed to reopen voter registration on October 11th until the 30th amid public clamor to extend it beyond today's deadline. The registration of overseas voters was also extended for 2 weeks until October 14th.
We made the decision to eat up whatever slack we might have had before, in order to accommodate this extension. Unfortunately, we can't do more than that. We can't give more than October 30th. Sagad na tayo talaga. There'd be less time to deal with unforeseen circumstances, and so you know it'll sort of ratchet up the pressure to get everything done the right way, at the first try. Big milestones like the printing of ballots. We're going to try to start that on time towards the end of the year pa rin.
So far, there are close to 63 million registered voters in the country. The COMELEC expects 300,000 more people to register during the extension period.